You ready?
I'm so ready.
Get our workout on? What you got for me today?
Back and buys. Hope you're ready.
Well, shit. Not excited for that.
Yeah, but you're gonna put me through legs, so I think I'm
the Oh, no. I'm not putting you through legs. I'm putting you through booty.
Oh.
We're gonna get you a bubble butt, a peach, by the end of this.
So we're going to struggle through each other's workouts, or maybe it'll be easy, who knows?
It's gonna be rough.
I think it's gonna be hard because we both train very differently, and we both train different parts of our body more often. Like, I definitely do back and buys, but not as much as Joel does, and then you do legs and butt, probably. I would assume. Like, I see you doing legs, but I never see you do, like, specifically the booty.
I do compound lifts for my legs and then some, like, individual stuff, but I don't, like, I do not have the booty you got, so today's gonna be tough. I might be walking funny tomorrow. So, like, after a good leg day, you're just like...
We're going to Florida, so I want him to show off.
She wants me to wear
his stuff
normal
in those
swim trunks
in those
and
swim
fill
shorts.
Them out a bit differently.
Yes, sir. You're going to be looking good on the beach.
Oh, man.
And I'm going to be looking jacked on the beach.
She's going to walk around like...
like...
Lats.
That is not cute. No. Those are typically not my goals in the gym. No. Okay, let's get into it because you're probably sick of us talking. So let's go to the gym.
Alrighty, you guys.
Welcome to our home gym.
Yeah, this is it. We've got our fan bike, battle ropes.
Battle ropes here. We've got our dumbbell set up here in front of the mirror.
Mm-hmm.
5 to 50, I love these. Dumbbells are like everything for a home gym because you can do so much with them.
They really are.
One of the biggest things for our home gym that we planned out was that everything would be multi-purposed. So you can do everything with dumbbells. You can do lower body, legs, upper body, push, pull, everything. They've got the beautiful squat rack. We got it in white metal, which I've never seen before. I think it is so cool looking.
Yeah, it looks so good.
It's the Titan series. And we got plates from 10 to 55.
Yeah.
I use this in every workout. I implement this in every single workout, whether it's compound lifts or strength training, heavy lifting. I use this every day.
The plates are
sexy.
Super, super sick.
There's no two ways about it. They're just sexy. Our plyometrics box. We got the 24 inch because the other options, we have such long legs that we actually got one of the bigger boxes so that we can actually get like effective depth because of our legs. So we went with the 24 inch in the black plastic wrap. It's super durable. And then we have the functional trainer. So
Joel loves this thing.
I really wanted this because it has an individual pulley system. Both of these go up and down, giving you two different height options. Mia and I've worked on this at the same time where I'm doing push downs and she's doing curls on the other side. You've got a pull-up bar here for multiple angles and width. I use this machine every single day as well. It is so nice. Also, with all the different attachments, you can do a full body workout on this, targeting different muscles on different days, or just like a proper full body workout on this. And then we've got our Muay Thai punching bag. I get on this sucker for
cardio. Love this thing.
I love this so much. I get to come in here and just let out some steam. We've got medicine balls, 10, 20, 30, and then we've got slam balls here. These are nice. You get such a sweat on those. Oh my goodness, it's ridiculous. And then, one of the most important things about a gym is music. This is one of the reasons why I love a home gym so much is that I get to control the vibe, the energy, and the music, and the music kind of sets that tone. We've got inspiration, we've got sweat towels, we've got just all sorts of stretching material. This is full of goodies. It's kind of a mess, so we keep it closed a lot of the time. And just some like accessories, gym accessories like wrist wraps and like gravity boots for like lengthening your spine, really good stuff. Also got our yoga mats for plyometrics and stretching. I love this green space that Mia's created. All sorts of movements can be done here. There's plenty of room for both of us. We've got our yoga ball, our Bosu ball for functionality and knee control. So
yeah,
this is my sanctuary. I love it in here. And
we're in here every single day.
Yeah, pretty much.
Alrighty, who wants to go first? Are you gonna
put me through the ringer first?
Really?
Yeah, let's do me first.
Yes. Okay. Get your mat.
Is this for drying my tears when I can't walk?
Yeah. Put it on the ground. And then I'm gonna get you some ankle weights.
Oh no. Oh no. Okay.
I feel like they're so small on you. I wish I had heavier ones.
No, I think this is heavy enough.
So first, you're gonna, go on your hands and knees. And then you're gonna go up in downward dog. No, like go back.
Oh, I'm sorry, like, I was thinking cat cow.
Downward dog, now put one foot up. And now start doing push-ups.
What?
And bring your leg back at the same time.
Like that?
No. You wanna bring your leg, like kick up.
But you said push-ups.
Yeah, and do them at the same time.
Like this?
I'm joking. You're good.
Oh my god, I was gonna say, like, how are you doing push-ups at the same time? That's so funny. You get me.
Okay, go back to hands and knees. Now you're gonna do donkey kicks. No.
No.
So. Yep, you're gonna do kicks.
Uh-huh.
Okay, bring one foot up, and you wanna push closer, and then do little movements. No, you don't wanna go that far down, yeah.
Oh, so you just keep
and each
it.
Time, yeah. You're contracting your gluteus maximus.
Okay, I feel this already.
You're gonna do 20 on each side.
What?
No breaks. Kick up, it's gotta go higher. Higher, my sweet.
This is all the mobility I have. I'm still working on it.
Little movements, bring your heel in. You gotta bring it in a little more, you're getting sloppy.
What do you mean in? Here?
Yeah. Like, not too much. Yeah, there you go. Up. But you wanna pause every time you hit up. So you go.
I can't pause. I think that's 20.
So every time, next one. Now every time you hit up, you wanna do a little pause. Yep. To contract the muscle.
I do not like this.
Good. Pause at the top. Pause. Pause. Kick. Pause. Okay, next workout.
Okay.
That's the warm up. Well, not yet. We have one more warm up.
What? I already have to grab a sweat towel. We're
going
to need
to. Look at his
ankle weights. Deep clean in here.
Okay. Oh yeah, look how sweaty.
I know.
Jeez.
That's nuts that you do 20 on each side.
Well, times 3.
So
20 on each side, 3 sets, no breaks.
20.
Well, you stop for like a second in between, stretch, and then do it again.
Okay.
I don't really take rest though when I work out. Like, I don't rest, I just keep going. But that's why my workouts are
badass. Whoa.
No, I make my workouts shorter.
But intense.
And intense. Because I don't like to be in here for so long. Next, you're gonna do squats, but you're gonna put your hands behind your neck, and then you're gonna go like this.
No, I am not. You're joking with me again.
No, I'm not.
Like yeah. That?
Yeah.
No.
Come on, we're gonna get your hips moving.
Like that? You're messing with me. Stop.
Okay. You're gonna do that, but you're gonna go in a full squat, but when you come up, you're gonna do it like that. So it's gonna be like...
Oh, nice. Okay, so activating like your IT band coming up.
Squat, this other side, yeah. Yep. And that's 20 times 3. Mm-hmm. And you still got your ankle weights on, so he's still getting a leg workout while he does this. He's activating his hips, his glutes, all his leg muscles.
Also, side abs, every time this contraction happens, like right here.
This is a really good warm-up I like to do.
Yeah, I feel warm.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah.
Nice. Good job, babe.
Okay, that's something like 20.
Okay. Next, you're gonna grab the BOSU ball.
Okay. Upside down or top side up?
Top side up.
Okay.
And put it right there.
Okay.
And you're gonna go from side to side, no handles.
Okay.
I'm gonna move this mat for you. And do you want me to show you? Or you think you know?
Can you explain it to me?
You're gonna like jump from side to side.
Oh, like a squat?
Yep. Mm-hmm. And that is 20 with 3 sets. And he's still got his ankle weights on, so it's a little bit more weight to move around.
Balancing.
Babe. It is great. This is something I do for coordination, mobility, and yeah, it really helps with my balance, so. This will definitely get you warmed up and ready. Nice, babe. You look good.
Said it too soon. These are killer.
They are.
Hey, turn the camera off. I'm doing fine.
How you doing?
Those BOSU ball squats, that's a great form of HIIT cardio.
It is.
You do like 30 seconds on, 30 seconds off.
You ready for your next workout?
Barely, those killed me. I still recovered.
Okay.
What's next?
Next, we're gonna get the plyometric box out.
No.
I absolutely love this thing from Titan. It kills your legs, basically. So you're gonna do just step up, and then bring the other foot up.
Okay, yeah.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Yep.
That.
Yep.
And then just here.
Yep. Nice. And you're gonna do 10 on each leg.
Ugh.
Times 3.
Ugh. Well, that explains why you have such phenomenal legs.
It's not that Jeez. Bad. Nice, babe. Killing it.
How's my booty looking?
Great. This is an awesome workout to bump up your cardio a bit, tone those legs, and you get the booty.
Also, so, tighter stability muscles.
Yep. So like even with sports, like snowboarding, surfing, it's gonna help with everyday sports that you like to do, which Joel and I like to do a lot of winter sports, summer sports. Right. Good job, babe.
That's killer.
But you have 2 more sets. Next up, I'm gonna have Joel do some cable donkey kicks.
Back through your heel?
Yeah. Doing okay?
This burns after everything else.
Yep. Good job, babe. Kick that booty back. Kick it back. Yeah. Kick it back. Booty's gonna be popping.
I'm dying.
Okay, you gotta switch.
No. Honestly, I love this cable machine.
Get it.
But now I hate it. That's 10.
What are we doing again? Back and buys?
Back and buys. So first off, you're gonna grab the red elastic strap.
Where is that?
From the bench. You're gonna throw it over the functional trainer in the center and make sure it's even so you pull down on it. And this is just a warm up. Face the functional trainer and step back. And then you're gonna pull, you keep your elbows flared out a little bit. And then what you're gonna do is you're gonna just extend your arms a little bit and then pull back your elbows, but keep your arms extended. So you're doing like reverse chest flies.
Like that?
Yeah. And then every other, make your elbows go flared out further. So this is basically all you're trying to do is just
activate.
Yeah, all you're trying to do right here is just activate these muscles on the back. See, look at that. Look how shredded my wife is. All this definition in here, she's just activating these muscles. So yeah, you'll do, like, I just do like 2 sets of 15 with this, just to just activate my back. That's really all. Definition!
Wow, this actually does hurt.
Yeah, you feel it, right?
Yeah. Oh my god.
Well, the goal isn't to hurt. All it is just to activate, so.
Oh, what's activating?
Nice bug.
Okay.
Nice, there you go.
So the first real part of your workout after your warm up is gonna be bent over barbell rows.
Okay.
So what you're gonna do is you're gonna keep your hands on the outside of your body, not too wide. I like to keep them pretty snug, but on the outside of your body.
Okay.
So what you're gonna do is you're gonna activate your lower back muscles and you're gonna go almost into like a deadlift form, like this. You're gonna go to about like here, 45-ish degrees angles on your hip.
Okay.
Is that right? I don't know if that's 45. Anyway, to about your knees.
Okay.
Then what you're gonna do is you're gonna pull through your elbows, almost to your belly button.
Okay.
So not like too high, not like none of that. You're gonna pull in.
Okay.
And you're gonna target your middle back.
Oh.
Pretty much right here.
And then kind of pull your elbows up, bar to your belly button. There you go.
Do that?
Yeah. And then with like good contractions, you'll be able to really feel it in your mid back. That's good form, Buck.
Is it?
Yeah.
Am I doing good?
Yeah, look at these abs, you guys. Killer. Killer abs. Nice job, love. There you go.
This really works.
Are you feeling it?
Yeah.
See, you guys, this activation of the muscles right here is right in there. Nice. You could basically hold a pencil with your scapula when you're squeezing them together like this. That's really great. Nice job, love. Really good form, there you go. And then you just do like 10 of these.
Times what?
I would do 4 sets and I would make my-
Four?
Yeah, I would make my weight go up.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
Wait, so
basically the failure.
Get better at this, then you can add weight.
Oh yeah.
Is that correct?
Oh yeah. Next up is dumbbell curls with a static hold. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna grab 2 dumbbells and while one curls, one is just gonna static hold.
Okay.
And these allow for time under tension, which really allows for a lot of like muscle growth and also strength. And this is so what I would do is I would start low like you, and then I would work my way up to like 20s, and I'm just like,
okay.
Killer. So what you're gonna do is just bring them both up to 90 degrees.
How many sets?
3 sets of like 10.
10.
10 each arm.
Okay.
So you bring it up, there you go. Static hold one, and then curl the other. Nice, there you go. All the way down. There you go. And a great thing to think about these is at the bottom to get the most range of motion is to actually flare your tricep at the bottom.
Oh.
And that gives you full extension of your arm.
Why does that look so weird on me? How come I can't do that?
Yeah, you just did it.
My elbows are kind of double jointed.
Oh, that makes it hard for you, I'm sure. Yeah.
Kind of looks.
Your arm bends like super far back.
Yeah, it goes
Yeah, like all the way back there. That's crazy, okay.
Is it?
I wasn't counting.
I don't know, I wasn't counting.
Okay, just switch. Yeah, so so then you'll static hold this one and curl on that one. There you go. Nice job, love. Dang, your arms look so good. Working hard. Nice. I think that's 10, maybe? Oh, love, you have to count.
Well, why don't you count? You're the coach.
I'm coaching. I'm not counting.
The coach is supposed to count.
I don't know about this. Put in the comments if you think coaches count.
Okay, I gotta get it.
If you're lifting the weights like that, you did not pick a high enough weight. And then you go up in weight, and then you do the exact same thing. Static hold and curl. Nice.
Gosh.
There you go, book. Nice. Boom. Your arms look really phenomenal.
Okay.
Nice. fight through, push. There you go. Nice.
Okay,
there you go. Okay, and as a back finisher, what we're gonna do is single arm lat pull downs at a time.
My arms are losing blood.
I'm sure. So, you're gonna, basically this is a finisher. I'll do as many rounds of this as I have to do until I just can't pull down on a realistic amount of weight anymore. So go for it. Rounds of 10.
Four, how many sets?
I usually do like 4 or 5.
Oh my God.
Yeah, it's a finisher set. It's just supposed to kill. There you go.
My shoulder popped.
Oh, did it?
Yeah.
Oh, interesting. Dang, your back looks great.
Really?
Yeah.
Nice. Well, that's good at least.
Nice. And you're gonna wanna make sure, well, the back is such an interesting muscle because what you could do is you can flare your back out a little bit.
Them.
You're pulling down to the back and rounding your lat out, which is really nice, pulling like down and then back into the other side like that. But what you can also do is kind of like activate your core and pull like your shoulders forward and kind of pull into your thigh and like the front of your hip is another thing that you can do. So it's really nice. Nice, babe. Really good form.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah. Elbow straight down to the hip. There you go. And then control the weight as it goes back up. That's big. This isn't about pulling the most amount of weight. This is about control and just absolutely killing your whatever you got left of strength. And aerobics, apparently.
Okay.
Nice job, love.
I'm done.
Okay, no, 5 more sets.
No.
Okay, not 5.
I'm exhausted.
Yeah.
For one.
You did a really good job on my workout.
You did a good job on my workout. I think we both surprised each other because there's a lot of workouts that neither of us have done before.
Yeah.
So you should definitely try this with a friend or partner or husband, wife, whatever it may be.
The cool thing about the workout community for me is that like it's a learning system and everyone has something that you can learn from. There's professionals and you can learn a lot from them.
Yeah.
But also like the Bosu ball, like jump squats where you're going from side to side. Like,
yeah.
I've never done that before.
Really?
That was awesome.
Yeah.
That was awesome. So you can always learn. And I think that's one of the cool things.
And thanks to Titan, we have been working out so consistently. Their equipment is literally the best, as you probably saw. It's so easy to work with.
Yeah.
It feels cool but not intimidating, which is very important for me.
Yeah.
Because I know that working out can be intimidating at times when you don't know what to do. So I also hope that you picked up a couple tips and tricks to use in the gym and just new workouts that you want to incorporate into your routine. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and turn on those notifications.
And also, go check out Titan because they have a lot more than this.
Yeah, I will link their website down below so you can check them out. And yeah.
Bye, everybody.
Bye.